Now, Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina is on a four-day visit to India. She will be meeting Prime Minister Narendra Modi today. And during the bilateral meet, Modi and Hasina are going to jointly inaugurate three projects. India and Bangladesh are also likely to sign seven agreements during the meeting. Addressing the media, Minister of External Affairs spokesperson Ravish Kumar said that the talks between the two leaders will revolve around trade connectivity, development, cooperation, people-to-people contact, culture and other issues of mutual interest. Sheikh Hasina's visit to India is aimed at taking the ties both between both the countries to the next level. Now, bilateral trade, of course, is blooming. It is valued at a little over $9 billion. So far, the progress on this issue has been promising. Sheikh Hasina has said that she is satisfied with the assurances given by Prime Minister Modi. In fact, it is this confidence and faith between both the leaders that is driving this partnership. During her visit, Hasina said that Bangladesh and India have the best of relations, giving Prime Minister Modi credit. Last year, the Indian Prime Minister had described this phase as the golden chapter of that much valued relationship between India and Bangladesh. For more details, let's quickly go across to our principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibbal, who's joining us live from New Delhi. He's been closely tracking the movement of the Bangladeshi Prime Minister. A very good morning to you, Siddhant. Siddhant, what remains significant is the issue of NRC and Assam, which has become a growing concern for Bangladeshis. Should we expect the issue to be addressed during today's bilateral?
Well, of course, Dhaka is going to raise this issue. In fact, this was raised during the Indian Prime Minister's meeting with the Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina last week on the sidelines of the United Nations General Assembly in New York, in which the Indian Prime Minister assured that Dhaka should not worry about the citizen's role which is NRC, which has been put in place, which is a Supreme Court mandated process in Assam. In fact, we know that the Indian Foreign Minister S. Jayashankar was in Dhaka, and this was one of the primary questions raised with him by the Bangladeshi Foreign Minister. So this remains one of the key issues when both the sides will be sitting. In fact, even as we speak, the Indian External Affairs Minister Jayashankar is meeting the Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina. The meeting started just 10 minutes ago, and we know that at 11:30, the formal meeting, the bilateral between the Indian Prime Minister and the Bangladeshi Prime Minister will be starting. And it's just not NRC, the issue of Rohingya crisis, the radicalization of Rohingyas, that the Bangladeshis have said that is a ticking time bomb for the South Asian region. This is another key issue. Other than that, we know Teesta water sharing agreement has been something that has been in limbo for a pretty long time, given the fact that the chief minister of the eastern state of West Bengal is dragging her feet. In fact, as of now, there is no meeting scheduled, and the Bangladeshi Prime Minister is also not going to Calcutta.
Right.
We know that the...
I'm sorry to butt in right now, Siddhant, but it's important to establish the fact that the Bangladeshi Prime Minister is right now meeting with the Foreign Minister, Dr. S. Jayashankar, while we speak. We just got in those live visuals. So this is an important development that has also been mentioned by you. Taking forward the discussion we were having from trade to Teesta River, even the issue of terrorism, that is something that, you know, was called out even during Sheikh Hasina's meeting with the Indian Prime Minister when that happened on the sidelines of the UNGA. What could be the other sticking points that will take place during today's bilateral between Prime Minister Modi and the Bangladeshi Prime Minister? Because let's not forget that's just going to happen after the Foreign Minister wraps up his meet with the Bangladesh Prime Minister.
Well, Akanksha, let's talk about terrorism first. This is an issue in which both Dhaka and New Delhi have their common concerns, and both are on the same page on this issue. Terror, especially emanating from Pakistan, because remember, after New Delhi announced that they will be boycotting SAARC summit a few years ago after the terror attack in the Indian state of Jammu and Kashmir, the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir, we saw Bangladesh backing New Delhi on that issue, and ties when it comes to Dhaka and Islamabad are also not very good, given the the fact that we know that how the notorious spy agency of Pakistan, ISI, before the elections in December of 2018 in Bangladesh, was trying to change the course of elections through its own funding process. But the other sticking point has been, ironically, onions, given the fact that New Delhi has banned export of onions to outside world, especially in the Asian region, because in the Asian region, countries like Nepal, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka are dependent on Indian onion.
Right.
And now the prices of onions have skyrocketed in these countries. In fact, this led the Bangladeshi Prime Minister to say, publicly acknowledge that she asked her cook not to put onions in her food.
Absolutely. That was, in, of course, a very light way in that she actually mentioned the price rise as far as onions are concerned. Now, that also remains a concern. But India and Bangladesh, it's important to talk about how these both these South Asian nations are part of the SAARC and BIMSTEC forum, which Sri Lanka and Nepal are also part of. But when it comes to the issue of Chinese intervention, Bangladesh has steered clear of a flip-flop, unlike Nepal and Sri Lanka. Drawing a contrast between India's neighbours, is Bangladesh's steadfast loyalty to India what makes this relationship actually stand out?
Well, I've been speaking to diplomats in Dhaka, and they have, this year, but in the past also, they have said that when it comes to China, they have studied the Chinese development model in the South Asian region, whether it's in Pakistan, whether it's in Nepal, and they do understand there is no point, there's a futility, in fact, of being too close or engaging with these infrastructure projects, because this might cause high debt problem, as is the case in Nepal and in Pakistan. So Bangladesh, which knows that India can be a better partner given the fact that there is proximity, geographical proximity, and ties between the two countries have grown closer in past few years, especially under the Modi government. In fact, this is the fourth visit of the Bangladeshi Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina in last 4 years. The first visit was in 2016 for the informal BRICS and BIMSTEC summit, then on a state visit.
Right.
Last year, she was again in Kolkata for the inauguration of Bangladesh Bhavan in Shanti Niketan. And again, she's here in Delhi. So that shows that high-level engagement between New Delhi and Dhaka clearly trusting New Delhi more than China.
Absolutely. This is indeed a high-level engagement. Let's expect things to go forward, keeping in mind that this is Sheikh Hasina's first visit to India after that mammoth victory she had in Bangladesh and, of course, the elections in India as well. Let's hope things move forward in the right direction for now. Thank you so much, Siddhant Sibbal, for bringing us all those details.
As the Bangladesh Prime Minister visits India, we take a close look at the bilateral relationship with a strategic neighbor. Amid focus on issues of trade, terror and territorial resources, the spotlight is also on India's citizenship register. Can two of the fastest growing economies in Asia iron out the pending issues? The Delhi-Dhaka dynamic. Special coverage only on VEON. World is One.